Welcome to this audio flip chart on miscalibration. My name is Manfred Frühwirth. I'm professor of finance at BU Wien, which is Vienna University of Economics and Business. The purpose of this audio flip chart is to explain the concept of miscalibration. Miscalibration is a very important facet of the overconfidence bias. Miscalibration means that people are too sure that their knowledge and their forecasts are correct. I want to illustrate this at the following example. Let us imagine that you have to forecast the future development of a stock price. In the chart, we see on the horizontal axis the time. As you are going to the right, time elapses. On the vertical axis, we see the stock price. Directly on the vertical axis, at time zero, we see today's stock price. Going to the right, we see future stock prices. For instance, at the blue horizontal position, we see the stock price after 5 years. Statistically, you know that future stock prices are uncertain. Nobody knows the future stock prices in advance. However, you can forecast future stock prices. This means that you can calculate the expected value of the stock price at a given future time. On the flip chart, the expected stock price for different future times is shown by the green line. But of course, we have to keep in mind that the future stock prices are risky. Therefore, they are subject to a probability distribution. The further we look into the future, the higher the risk of the underlying stock price. Thus, the wider the probability density function. Now, once you have forecasted future stock prices, you can select a probability P. Based on this probability, for each future point in time, you can build a confidence interval around your stock price forecast. This confidence interval builds a range within which the stock price will be with that probability P. So, for each point in time, there is a lower boundary and an upper boundary, and the future stock price will be within that interval with the given probability P. The higher the probability P that you select, the wider the confidence interval has to be. Therefore, the forecast in green is surrounded by a lower boundary line and an upper boundary line. For instance, on this flip chart, we see the true confidence interval or objective confidence interval for the stock price at each future point in time, represented by the two black lines. You see that the two lines are quite distant, which means that there is a relatively wide range where the future stock price may be with the given probability. For instance, for the stock price after 5 years, we can see the interval by the ends of the two black arrows. Now let us assume that the confidence intervals are established by someone who is not subject to any bias. This person is able to state perfectly correct confidence intervals as shown here in black. However, as defined before, people who are subject to miscalibration are too sure that they can predict things. As a result, they are underestimating the risk and therefore quote too narrow confidence intervals. Therefore, the upper boundary perceived and quoted by a miscalibrated person will be smaller than appropriate, and the lower boundary perceived and quoted by a miscalibrated person will be higher than appropriate. Now this is true for each point in time in our example. For instance, the confidence interval for the stock price after 5 years, as perceived by a miscalibrated person, is shown by the ends of the two red arrows, which is smaller than the true confidence interval that is illustrated by the black arrows. The perceived confidence interval for the stock price at each point in time is illustrated by the two red lines. Unfortunately, as psychological literature shows, miscalibration happens very often in practice, both with estimations and with questions of knowledge. Summing up, we saw in this audio flip chart that miscalibration makes people underestimate the risk of random variables, which means the risk of uncertain developments. So miscalibration results in the so-called risk bias of overconfidence. And this in turn makes them perceive and quote too small confidence intervals. As a result, miscalibrated people do not see the full scope of risk and therefore often take a too high risk. I hope that you now better understand this interesting facet of overconfidence, that you try to avoid this psychological trap in the future. I hope that you enjoyed this audio flip chart. Thank you very much for watching.